Print making is very special for me actually, especially lithography, stone lithography, not plate lithography. Stone lithography gives some kind of, you know, attachment I grow, which weight of the stone also give some kind of depth I can at least express in that stone. Instead of paper or a canvas, it is too light for me. While I'm working in stone, I feel like more intimate and more heavy, because I work with lots of black, now very heavy black. So that heavy black, I think like only stone can carry. Like when I was in Europe, studying in Copenhagen and moving around in different countries and living in Norway, being a very successful artist there also, I got quite many awards also in Norwegian Academy, from Danish Royal Academy also I got award, and I've been considered a year of the artist also in Denmark. Everything, this all success what I see, and I had quite much good money also, but this, I was inside me, there is some kind of things is haunting, like this is my success only, this is only me and myself, and one day maybe I will be end with quite much good money, with a very good house and everything, but I had a house in Norway, I had children, but I just came back because all my resources, all my things are actually around this nature in Assam. The resource I got, the inspiration, I need that to be alive as an artist. Also, I start thinking, I must share what I know to my people who is so backward in comparison to like a first European world or a Western world or a contemporary world. Another thing is there, while I come back, when I was in Europe, then I had so many questions from lots of people about the people here. I have little knowledge. That little knowledge actually haunting me. I need to know more knowledge about my people here. Like so many, like hundreds of tribes lives here, hundreds of different icons are there, like hundreds of different rituals are there, where there is lots of like a visual references, like references for the new installation, for a new expression, new media of art. So I come back, I start working with different group of tribals, Karbi, Missing, then all other like different group of tribes, and I studied them and studied their lots of things, their totems, their icons, their visual elements, textile designs. Then I working in that island Majuli also, for all these monastery people, and they are like a very organized, civilized art tradition, like painted manuscript, illustrated manuscripts, to like a wood carving, to very sophisticated one, the parallel. And then another is like a very indigenous one. The both I compare and both I study. Now also I start thinking, I must share what I know to my people who is so backward in comparison to like a first European world or a Western world or a contemporary world. So almost I invested myself, come back and join in this very small college to push and promote students in the college to a national standard, nowadays in international standard. My great teacher, his name is Sanat Kaur. He was in Bengal, in Shantiniketan. He was my HOD. His like support and counseling was really good, really helpful for me. I just mentioned one guru. He is my guru only. I have lots of teachers, but he was my guru. Then another thing also, like in my like spontaneous works, that blooming out, suddenly I have been start working a lot. One friend of mine have a kind of a little bit of contribution. One friend of mine while I was studying. So I was very much in love with her. And she had some other boyfriend. So it's become like a kind of an electron work on my brain. I cannot be achieve you, but I can, that intensity I'm having towards you, I can convert to my stone to express like all the feelings. So that's the kind of electron has worked long time ago. It's more than 40 years maybe, long time ago, that has been working. Sometimes I need that kind of sparks.
I don't need a somebody to be mine, but somebody is having that kind of a, like a, who can click my sparks in my heart and brain. So I feel so strong to express, actually. It is like a windows to be open in the brain. It is dark windows. And if you open, if you go and be there, then slowly start seeing everything. It's like a, going into the black and you are not seeing anything. But slowly, you see all the objects, slowly. It's not suddenly you can see. It takes time, but slowly it becomes light within the black. It is the depth, but not black actually. It is the depth. Meaning it is the darkness of depth of the three-dimensional space. It is not flat black. It is transparent and three-dimensional black where you can go into and slowly start seeing everything. Again, you can go into, it's become more and more light and more things. Things means the feelings I start seeing. The feelings I can express through that black window. Source of inspiration is there, whole society is there. Whole mighty nature is there. All social conflicts are there. Social like a pain are there. Pleasures are there. Everything is there around. Only people must open their mind and eyes of the mind. Not this eye to just see an object, not to feel it, then meaningless. So here, it is here in the like third eyes. All, I believe that all artists have a kind of a third eye, but they don't know how to use the third eye to feel it. So I believe that thing. Actually, lots of people are now, they are working very surfacially, what I find, like new generation. They are taking icons from the, taking motifs from the internet, taking motifs from like here and there, and they are mathematically, they are composing lots of work. So I don't think so that is real work for a artist. Artists have to find out their own self first, own inside, and to express it in a new kind of a, like a medium maybe. Maybe installation, maybe like a public art, maybe a lithography, whatever it is. But the feeling should be real, original and real from the artist. That is my advice. Use their own intuition and own world instead of using somebody else's world to compose like mathematically. I love to share like humanity and affection, the first thing. First thing, I am very much liking my students and I am giving lots of affection to them, like my own. I don't think this is the job for me. My job is, I think, it is a kind of a, you know, that intimate relations to the other beings, other people whom I love, to teach the good feeling, good affection, sharing love and affection. Without sharing love and affection, without being a very affectionate, good human being, you cannot be an artist, I don't think so. Lots of people think I'm a bad because my behavior is not good. Maybe sometimes I'm shouting, sometimes I'm not perfect for so many people. And you know, he is too much. He's so much free to speak it out, everything. So that's me, actually. If somebody likes it, if somebody doesn't like it. But I love to, I have a like a kind of a message for all new generation artists to be a good human being first, sensitive and good human being. Then you become an artist after.